I thought perhaps you'd prefer something a little stronger than coffee.
You've got second sight. Thanks. I'm afraid I went on rather longer than I intended. I ought to have left time for questions.
Oh, I'm sure there'll be plenty of opportunity during the rest of your stay. Oh, I am.
You're staying on in Edinburgh?
I'm in no hurry to get back to Cambridge. I've heard of one or two things happening here that are in my field of work.
Oh?
Oh, yes. Nowadays, hallucinogenic drugs are everywhere. And inevitably, they give rise first to a sense of mysticism and then perhaps to ceremony and cults. And what more fertile ground than a grey northern city?
You surprise me, Dr. Wyszrewski.
Edinburgh surprises me, Dr. Reynolds. Roy was telling me of an incident that occurred recently.
Hamish.
Well, you're surely not suggesting that Hamish was on hallucinogenic drugs when he murdered his girlfriend. There was a lot more to it than that.
No African leaves the witch doctor far behind. And there can't be a better example of a combination of skills than the African witch doctor.
In what sense?
In the sense that they utilize organic drugs of known effect in combination with the encouragement of psychic states, states of frenzy, of hallucination, of
possession.
They attack both the body and the mind at the same time. And in the battle for the mind, possession is 9/10 of the war.
I don't think Hamish is a joking matter, Dr. Wyszrewski. He did kill someone.
I beg your pardon.
And it was more than an accident.
Possession does seem to me to be the most likely explanation. The police found more than tribal artifacts in his room.
Hamish was the victim of modern, not ancient, techniques. He was primed to kill, but he was triggered too early.
How unfortunate.
Unfortunate? A girl died.
That was Tiff.
Oh, come on, Roy.
Love can do strange things to people, Mr. Crane. It's a form of possession, particularly when there's an estrangement or grief. That combined, perhaps, with drug use, it's a terrible weapon. It can overcome all rationality.
Hamish was not possessed by love. He was brainwashed.
Let me get you another drink. Anne?
Yes, please.
Perhaps you and Tom would care to join Dr. Wyszrewski and myself for dinner tonight.
Ah, it's a nice idea, but we'd planned a quiet evening.
I like your idea of a quiet evening.
saw Julia again.
You had too much to drink.
No, I swear it was her. I mean, the style of dancing, everything.
This afternoon it was the walk. Did you see her face?
No.
Tom, there are a lot of people in the world. Some are bound to walk the same way. Look, they're nearly all dancing.
She was my wife. It was her. Take these to the table. I want to go and look. I've got to look. I swear it was her.
She's dead. She's been dead for months.
Sorry. What do you want to do?
Let's just go home.
Okay.
Oh, you're a quiet evening, Mr. Crane.
Yeah, well, we got sidetracked. Begins now.
Hey, you're surprised to see me here, a serious academic. I like dancing, I like pop music, why not? And besides, what better place to study possession and psychedelic effects? I love that dress. Come on, let's dance.